Hi, I'm Rich at New Life Scientific, and today I want to show off this beautiful, almost like new machine. And the reason I say that is because it only has 6 hours on this. It's a 2019 Microfluidics M-110P, and this is the newest generation with the touch screen on it. This is the 30,000 PSI machine. And right now you can see we're actually in the home screen where you would just turn the motor on and an intensifier, and then you can just simply adjust your pressures with the slide switch or with the incremental up and down. But first I want to go over to the information and just show off. You can see total hours, 6 hours, and then total strokes, 3,818. Now, just the service on this is not even close to being due at 150,000 strokes or at 500 hours. But I also want to go over to the alarms page and just show you back in, looks like March 5th of 2020 is where everything was recorded. And there was a lot of emergency stops on there. And one thing about this machine is that it is only a 110, which is really nice. But if you plug it into an outlet that isn't fully designated 20 amp breaker, just specifically for this machine, you'll actually kick the breaker and it's going to give an emergency stop error. And that's one of the reasons I think it has so many on here, is because it is a 110 and it has kicked some breakers. But having a good designated outlet with a 20 amp is sufficient for it. It works fine. That's what I have it plugged into now. But like I said, it looks like it may not even have been used and just plugged in, because some of the things it said connection established. So it looks like they were actually, and you know, this is my theory, this is right before COVID, right? And so, you know, we started having all the lockdowns, and maybe a project was getting started and then boom, everything was shut down and then it set. So just a theory of mine, but anyways, like I said, 6 hours of use if it was even ran anything through it. Now, just because I always get these machines in, I always disassemble them and take everything apart, because if it had been used, I want to thoroughly clean it. So when I broke it down and looked at it, I could see no signs of use. I broke the pump head down. And while I was in there, I just went ahead and put new seals on the tip, seals on the actual piston in there, just because I wanted a new one in there. And you know, you never know if it would have set too long and maybe, you know, started dry rotting or something. But so I just wanted to reassure you that it does have new tips put in it. And then of course I did flush it really good. Like I said, that's just my typical procedure with these machines. So even though it only had 6 hours, went ahead and done the same thing. It does have a diamond mixing chamber on it. It has, I think, 100 micron here. And it also has the pressure gauge. And this is one nice thing that I really like too. The pressure gauge actually has a shutoff valve. Now, to me, I think they just started putting these on. But what happens is the pressure gauges aren't really meant to have constant hammering of pressure. In other words, it would be fine if you would just get a pressure and it would just maintain that pressure. But this is under a hammering type scenario where, and when we run it, you'll see, but it just shoots the gauge up to 30,000 PSI and drops off, shoots it up, drops off, shoots it up, drops off. So that's really hard on gauges. So once you've established your set pressures, just shutting the valve clear off, and then it really conserves and keeps the damage from getting into the pressure gauge. And I've seen many cases where the pressure gauge start leaking because of that hammering effect. So anyways, that's a nice feature. And also it does have the cooling bath here. So, you know, when you're running a lot of runs, and it has the coil in here, and so you can just run water into it and then just, you know, put it in drain and just have water trickling in it, and just keep the coil cool, because it will get hot. It builds a lot of friction coming through that mixing chamber there. So with all that said, we're gonna go ahead and fire this thing up. So we'll go back over here to the home again, And first thing we do is just hit the motor start, and super quiet machine. This, the newest generation machine, they did some things to it that are even more quieter than the older machines that have just the push buttons on it and they don't have the touch screen. But so after you do that, you can, like I said, you can set your pressure over here, but you really don't know your pressures until you get it started. So go ahead and turn the intensifier on, and that will get it started. So you can kind of hear it, and you can see the gauge where we're at. We're at about 25,000 PSI. I turned the slide down a little bit. So you can see from that point, you can make adjustments over here, and we'll just go ahead and slide this all the way up. Let me get my finger on there. Oh, I gotta use my right hand. My left hand won't do it. There we go. So that's full power. And you can see it's just shy of 30,000. And I'm just running water through it right now. But if we were actually running anything that was actually mixing, it would drive it on up to 30 and maybe a little past. But down here you can just see, you know, it's coming through, going through the cooling coil and coming up through here. And then we're just, you know, you can see it, the water coming out and it's going down to my jug. So, you know, I don't know how well the audio on the video is here, but it's definitely much quieter than the last generation of machines. So that's one nice thing I really liked about it. But just super shocked when we got it in. It only had 6 hours on it. And honestly, it only had 5 hours in it when I got it, but because of the amount of time I ran it, got it up to 6 hours. So I put 20% more hours on this machine, just running it and testing it, if you could say it that way. But anyways, 2019, ready for production. I've got tools and parts. Like I said, I would rebuild all the machines. I only put the new tip seals on this one just because it was so new, but I deal in these, I work on them, and I can answer any questions for you. So thank you for watching, and like I said, Rich at New Life Scientific.